It is with a keen feeling of gratification and of honor, and with a far keener sense of responsibility, that I address the sponsors and friends of the Boys Clubs of America. The gratification is founded upon something very close to my heart, the realization that day by day there is a greater awakening to the tremendous necessity of building a bulwark against the ravages of crime during the early ages of its potential victims. Once the tentacles of crime have seized a youth, once its filth has soiled the possibilities of a young man's existence, once the dirt and grime of jails and reformatories, of criminal associations and hideouts, the mental stench of degrading influences and companionships have placed their stamp upon the easily molded mentality of youth, there arises an almost insurmountable task for those who labor toward the building of a better citizenship. Crime is to a degree indelible. It leaves vicious scars, both for the perpetrator as well as for the victim. The progress of youth from his first semi-innocent participation in the minor infractions of a street corner gang through the weary course of police stations, juvenile courts, higher places of justice, reformatories, penitentiaries, and perhaps even to the execution chamber is such that it seems to continue and to contaminate everyone with whom the victim comes in contact, the innocent as well as the guilty. Do you suppose that the honest called public rats are proud of the fact that one of their clan has gone to the activities of major crime and extending over vast areas? There are 3,500,000 criminals actively at work in this country today. We shall dispense for the moment with millions of petty crimes, which often are not even reported. The main picture, the forbidding one, is that 1,500,000 felonies, major infractions, crimes worthy of penitentiary punishment, which each year are committed within the boundaries of the United States. I shall digress for a moment to point out the effect of a single crime. A youth commits a murder.